Want to create more effective searches on LinkedIn to reach your target audience? If so, then LinkedIn's Boolean searches are for you. In this video, I'm going to walk you through a simple tutorial on how to use Boolean searches and operators so that you can reach your ideal prospects easily on LinkedIn. I'm also going to show you how to use the Boolean operators in the free search as well as in LinkedIn Sales Navigator search, depending on which you use. So let's get straight to it.
Okay, let's dive straight in. First, I want to define what is a Boolean search. Boolean searches allow you to combine words and phrases in order to create either more refined searches or to create broader searches. So we can do both. We can refine our search using the Boolean operators, or we can create more broader searches. So the operators that we are going to use, these are the phrases or words that we're going to use in order to create the Boolean search. We can use quotes, and then I'm going to show you each of these in a second. And, or, not, and parentheses. So keep in mind when I'm using these three, and, or, and not, they have to be all caps in order for this to work. So let's look at the first one, quotes. I am going to use quotes or quotation marks for exact match search results. So if, for example, I want to search for career coach, I can use the quotation marks for an exact match. Let's look at an example. So if I head over to LinkedIn, I could type in career coach, and this is going to give me everybody that has the exact phrase or term career coach on their profile. If I don't use the quotation marks and I just say career coach without that, what this is going to pull up is people that have career and people that have coach in their profiles. So I could get leadership coach or mindset coach, and it's not going to be the exact match that I'm looking for. So if you're looking for a very specific term, you want to just put it in quotes or quotation marks so that LinkedIn can deliver exact match results. I can use the operator and to include specific criteria. So this means I want all of the keywords to be present in one person's profile. Let's go back to the example of career coach for this to make sense just a little bit more. So if I'm searching for career coach, but I also want people that specialize in branding, I want those two to be present on one person's profile. So I want someone that's a career coach that specializes in branding. I could use the operator and this is going to include them in my search. What this does generally is it limits my search. So I'm going to get a smaller search volume here. This is going to make sense a little bit more in a second when I show you an example. So here, if I go to people and I'm looking for career coach, I have 46,000 results. If I add and branding, so this means that both of these phrases or keywords need to be present in each person's profile. If I click search, so I want career coaches that specialize in branding, remember this limits my search. So now I have 4,000 results. So what the and operator allows you to do to get more specific and to include very specific criteria. So in this case, all the results that I have here are people that are career coaches and they specialize in branding, for example. So I can say here, I have career coach, personal brand, career coach, branding consultant, and includes people in my search criteria. Let's see the use of or. I will use or to include more than one item in a list. So think about apples or oranges. Well, I want both. So LinkedIn is going to deliver both of those in my search. So what I can do here is, for example, I want to search for career coaches, but I also want to search for career counselors. I can use or because that's going to include both of those terms into my search. So let's copy and paste this and see what it pulls up. So I can paste that career coach or career counselor. So remember, this is going to include more people into my search. So what LinkedIn is going to pull up here is they're going to pull up people that have career coach on their profile. And they're also going to pull up people that have career counselor on their profile. So I can see career counselor. I can see career coach and counselor. So I'm getting both of those included in my search. And what this allows you to do by using all is it generally broadens your search. So if I have a certain keyword, I can include more of those keywords in my search to broaden my search. Let's have a look at how this works. If I just look at career coach on its own without career counselor, I have 46,000 results. But if I say career coach or career counselor, and remember I need to have that in caps, counselor, this gives me 87,000 results. So using or broadens my search. Let's look at the next one, the use of not. I am going to use not to exclude phrases from my search. So say for example, I want to search for CEOs, but I don't want want assistants to show up in my search. Because sometimes if I'm looking for CEOs, sometimes I could have assistant, because it could say the assistant to the CEO or the assistant to the owner. So I could say I'm looking for CEOs, but I don't want assistants to pop up in my search. So this gives me a very, very big, very broad search, but I know as I scroll through this, there are going to be no assistants in my search. So remember, use not to exclude certain search terms. Maybe in this case, I want to look for CEO that is maybe not the owner or founder of the company. So I could say CEO and not owner. So this is going to show me people that are the CEO of the company, but they're actually not the owner of the company. And that's going to pull up those search results. So remember, use not to exclude. And then last but not least, you want to use parentheses when you have multiple search criteria. So if, for example, I'm using and or and not in the same search in order not to confuse LinkedIn and in order not to get very crazy search, I'm going to use parentheses because this is just going to tell LinkedIn what to prioritize. Just like in math, when you start with the parentheses, it's going to tell LinkedIn the exact same thing. It's really going to help me create a good search because I have multiple search criteria. So for example, I could put this into LinkedIn where I say, I want people that are in marketing that also specialize in branding, but I don't want them, I'm going to exclude assistants, those that are interns, and those that have communications on their profiles. So you could see here, I used and because I want both of these present on one person's profile, people that work in branding, in marketing rather, and specialize in branding, but I don't want to include assistants, interns, and communication. So let's put this into LinkedIn and see what it pops up. So I can see all the people that are here have marketing and branding on their profiles. Okay, so I could see here marketing, branding, marketing, branding, marketing, branding, but I have excluded assistants, interns, and anybody that has the term communications in their profile. So using the parentheses really helps you to refine your search if you are using multiple operators. Now I've really shown you how to use this in the free search. Now let's head over to LinkedIn Sales Navigator, because if you have LinkedIn Sales Navigator, sometimes you really don't need the Boolean search operators because, you know, LinkedIn Sales Navigator gives you the different options on how you can filter it. But here's how me and my team utilize the Boolean operators when I'm doing a LinkedIn Sales Navigator search. So say, for example, I want to look for owners and founders, people that have this as their current job title. You can see I've used the exact match because LinkedIn Sales Navigator is not perfect. So I still want to tell LinkedIn the exact titles that I want to look for. So I've utilized the exact match here. I've inserted the company headcount, 11 to 50. I've utilized the industry filter. This is the industry I want them to be in, the geography, and the connections. So all of this has pulled up people that are owners and founders with these various filters. So how I can actually use some of the additional Boolean operators is in the keyword section right at the top. So once I'm looking at my search and I want to further refine it, what I can actually do is insert some not keywords to further refine my search. So for example, here I found that when I was doing the search, I got a lot of solo, students, freelancers, interns, and assistants. So I simply included that because remember, LinkedIn search is not perfect. I simply included them as not keywords. So I said not solo or student or freelancer or freelance, etc., etc. And that really helped me to better refine my search. If I remove this, I just want to show you. So I have 11,000 results right now with that filter using the not keywords. If I search for it without those not keywords, it gives me 15,000 results. So I have 15,000 results. That means it's not as refined, but as soon as I put in some more Boolean operators and certain keywords that I want to exclude, it actually takes my search results down to 11,000. So you can utilize this section to really help you further refine your search. I hope that you found this video useful. If you did, please give it a like. And I want you to watch this video next, where I walk you through exactly how to use LinkedIn Sales Navigator to get meetings with your ideal prospects. I'll see you there.